we are back. You are listening to The Marilu Show. I'm Marilu Henner, talking to you from New York City. Jessica Davis in our Hollywood, California studio. And we have a fabulous guest. I'm so excited that she is on it. She is an actress, an author, a speaker. She's the originator of the pole dance fitness and striptease phenomenon. And when I first read about her in 2002 in the LA Times, I thought, boy, this girl's got it going on. I knew her work from LA Law and from Sisters, and I knew that she was married to the fabulous actor Richard Schiff, who's on West Wing, but she's incredible. She does all of these things, and she discovered the physical and emotional benefits of pole dancing while researching a film role. And how many actresses would actually have the wherewithal to take something that they felt so good about as they worked on a character and then turn it into a national business? I mean, she's also offering for our listeners today they get to attend a powerful weekend with her. Which is, and it's live, it's the Body Bliss event at the JW Marriott in Palm Desert, California. So let's give a nice, warm Marilu Show welcome to my guest, Sheila Kelley. Oh, Sheila.
Hi. Hi,
our phones are on fire. Hi, hon.
Hi, y'all. How are you?
I'm good. I'm so excited that you're on.
Me too.
You and I met at Lisa Rinna's party, and then all of a sudden, I had to leave town the next day. So I didn't get to come in and take your class. But as soon as I'm back, I'm taking the class, and I got to hear about the whole journey. Because it's been going on for a while, and now it's out there. And it's so, you know, when was that spark of inspiration? What did you do that you said, wow, other women have to do this?
You know what? I was doing that movie, Dancing at the Blue Iguana. It's a movie that I produced, and it also it came out, I believe, in 2000 was the year that it was out in the theaters. And I had to learn how to do this movement, and I had to develop a character based on myself and my own sexuality because it was an improvisational film. And I went to the rehearsals, and I went to the strip clubs, and I realized that I had absolutely no idea how to feel and live and be in my sexuality, in my everyday life, right? So, my husband and I are fine in our private relationship.
Right.
But to be out in the world and own and live in my sexy and my sexuality was something that was, like, completely foreign to me. So, during the making of the improvisational development, I started to really delve deep inside and learning the movement of the pole dancing and striptease, learning the big, round, curvaceous, sensual movements, brought something out inside of me that started to carry through in my entire life, my everyday life. I started to be more vibrant, more energetic, more passionate, more joyful, more in touch with myself as a feminine being as opposed to just a being. As opposed to a masculine being, but to really get in touch with what I call the five feminine geniuses. I just started to, like, literally, I would leap out of bed earlier in the morning, and just getting out of bed was not a chore. I would just pop up out of bed. I carried myself through life really effortlessly.
And you're in a relationship, so it's not like all of a sudden you were, like, giving it away for free to everybody. It's what,
no.
I think a lot of times people, you know, because I've been teaching classes for a long time in health and nutrition on my website, marilu.com, and I think a lot of times women especially put on this body armor in order to protect themselves and hide from the sexual creature that they know is lurking and waiting to get out inside of them. And, you know,
absolutely.
I've heard a lot of women over the years say, oh, I don't want to lose the weight because as soon as I start to get thin, I feel like, you know, people want me, or I have to deal with sexual pressure from people, or I want them. And I don't think it's that. I don't think
you're giving it away
for free now.
No,
you know?
But Marilu, you know what I call that? Because you really put your finger on something that's rampant in the world for women. You know, I did a TEDx talk last November, and I talk about this. What happens to women is their bodies are so under a microscope from the time they start to blossom till their entire lives. They're being criticized. they're not this enough, they're not that of that, you know, they're too this way, they're too that way, that the female body starts to become boundaryless. They start to feel like they have no boundary. So they hide in tension of the muscle. They hide in weight. They hide in clothing. They hide their God-given power and beauty in so many ways so that they don't feel like they're being constantly infiltrated or perforated by everybody's eyes and opinions and ideas. It's really kind of
exactly.
an epidemic. It's really bad. And so what
it
class does, yeah, what my class does is it creates, you will create boundaries. You will create a language and a fluid, like a fluid, luscious language of the female body for yourself in the privacy of my studios, in the privacy mm-hmm. of the Palm Desert studio, where you start to blossom. That's the best way I could describe it, is you really start to
Oh, I'm sure you've seen amazing transformations in people.
Oh, girl.
Because all of a sudden, someone gives them permission to
yes.
express themselves in a way. And it's funny, because we were talking about fat shaming earlier in the show, and how, you know, it's the worst way to bring about effective, any kind of
Horrible.
Effective health habits or any kind of effective weight loss for people who might be overweight, that it actually causes the reverse problem, because then their body starts to hoard. And that is exactly what women do when they hide
yes.
and they're shameful and they're self-critical in a negative, ugly way.
It becomes self-destructive. You start to take all the offenses. You start to take the shaming and the offenses internally, because then you start to self-shame and you start to self-offend. And that's the worst thing that could possibly happen. And then, and there's another program I do where I have women identify what I call her supervillain. And when she identifies a supervillain in her body, she befriends her instead of tries to get rid of her. Because
mm-hmm.
once you befriend what's inside of yourself, that kind of amazing energy, nothing can stop you. Like, nothing can stop you to get what you want in life, to move towards your bliss, to live in your bliss. And that's
right.
what I teach. That's what I'm passionate about. Because too many times women take it upon themselves.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy what starts to happen, you know. And I'm sure, you know, I'm from the school of, if you can't hide it, decorate it, you know. And so this puts like this like puts a nice big bow on everything, you know. It's funny, because I, you know, when I talk like this, people always think that I mean, oh, let's all go out and find our inner slut. Well, maybe that's a little part of it, because we want to find the inner slut for our husbands, and they certainly like it, and, you know, whatever. And but it's not about that.
No, you also want to. It's not about that at all. I call it discovering your erotic creature.
Yes.
And discovering your erotic creature for yourself, not for
right.
anybody else. And because
yeah.
it will bleed into the rest of your life. It will permeate other parts of your life. But the erotic creature is what I lovingly call the feminine body. Erotic
mm-hmm.
is feminine. The feminine is an erotic creature, and the creature is the body. So awakening, first of all, the female body, the mature female body, is a sexual creature. And that's just the way God made our bodies, right? It's the way that
mm-hmm.
our
Absolutely.
Bodies speak. And we have curves, we have breasts, we have a waist indentation, we have handles, we have all kinds of communicative body parts. And from the minute you have your first moment of what I call the first offense, the first shaming, the first self-conscious moment, I don't know, maybe you're 12 or 13 years old in your life, you start to try and control that body. You try and shut it down. You try and lessen the voice of your sexuality.
Mm-hmm. Or you start to do it for other people. You know, you start,
you start to yes,
or, mold or it for other people.
Exactly.
You know,
or
to somebody else's standards.
Yeah. Well, I would use the word exploit, because you don't
mm-hmm.
live it, you exploit it. And instead of living in the genius of the feminine body, you exploit the external presentational sexuality. I believe there are five layers of sexy. The
mm-hmm.
first layer of sexy is flatline. It's what we do. It's what so many of us have done, and I've done it in my life. You flatline yourself. You just don't even want to go there, because it's too vulnerable. It's too perforated. It's too scary. The second
and sexuality means responsibility, and you don't want to take
yes.
responsibility for it. And that's
exactly
a big thing
right.
with people.
It's a huge thing. It's a huge thing. So getting a woman out of flatline is the first step of getting into your sexy, into your erotic future. The next layer is what I call presentational. It's what's the color of my hair, what's the style of my hair, how do I wear my clothes, how do I present my body, how do I present the voice of the curve and the sexuality of my body. Now, in presentational, you have subtle presentational, you have overt presentational, and then you have what I call weaponry, using your sexuality as a weapon, using mm-hmm. your sexuality as something to manipulate. And that's not...
Right, which is not healthy either. Yeah.
I do not respect that. I don't think it's the right thing to do. But it's using your body. Instead of living beautifully and listening to the voice of your body and presenting your beauty the way your body feels comfortable and safe. And the third layer is animated. And that's how you move your sexuality. How do you move with grace and ease and releasing all the chronic contraction, releasing the shame, and moving through your beauty and through your sensuality? The fourth stage or layer is what I call emotional. What is the emotional core of your sexuality? Because your sexuality has an emotional essence. And when you discover that emotional essence, you discover your erotic future's soulful connection to her sexuality. And people like Cecile Wren, Angelina Jolie, these are women who have found a soulful connection to their sexuality that is riveting and powerful and can move mountains.
And that's one of the reasons why we want to watch them. We're going to be right, you're going to stick around with us because we have so much more to talk to you about. So I want you to save the fifth one for after the break because we're going to take, we're going to have a couple of commercials first. And we have callers on the line and we're going to be taking the first caller because I know that you've been generous to give the first lucky caller a powerful weekend with Sheila Kelley live, the Body Bliss event at the JW Marriott in Palm Desert, California. So I definitely want to find out more about that.
You got it.
That is September 7th and 8th. And just so the caller knows that you're not offering airfare, of course, but you are offering them the classes. Is that correct?
That's right.
So
absolutely.
We know.
Admission to the event.
Yes, admission to the event. So that's like such a great thing, and that's very generous of you. So thank you for that. We'll be talking more with Sheila Kelley, who is the founder of S Factor Fitness. That's how you say it, right? And you can tell us all about that as well. Can't wait to talk to her more back after these messages.
Gonna be. Are you gonna give your love to me?
Okay, and we are back. You are listening to The Mary Lou Show. I'm talking to you from beautiful New York City, where I'm doing The Tale of the Allergist's Wife, starting on August 15th at Bucks County. I'm here rehearsing right now. Jessica Davis is in our studio in Hollywood, California, and we have with us a very special guest, Sheila Kelley, who's an actress, an author, a speaker, and the originator of the pole dance fitness and striptease phenomenon, and she has studios all over the country named The S Factor, and also a book called The S Factor, Strip Workouts for Every Woman. And I'll tell you, I mean, it's so great that you took what you learned as an actress for a role and turned it into this phenomenon. And you were the first. You were doing
Absolutely.
This over 10 years ago.
In 2003 is the first time I was on Oprah. I was on her show twice. And then Terry Hatcher saw my appearance, and she came to class, and 3 months later scored Desperate Housewives. Because what I believe into the very core of my soul is when you are able to wrangle your sexual energy and use it in your everyday life, you will knock down every wall that's keeping you from getting what you want. So,
absolutely.
It was astounding to watch her rise, too. And then when she did the circuit, she asked me if she could talk about S Factor because it changed her life. It helped her get the role on Desperate Housewives. And so I was like, yes. And then she was on Oprah again, and all the five Desperate Housewives were on the Oprah show 2005. And Oprah told me that subsequently that 75% of all emails, phone calls, and mail was about the 5-minute segment that Terry did showing her S-Factor movement.
See that?
Women are hungry.
They're like waiting for permission. Absolutely.
They're waiting for permission, but they're also waiting for
how do I do it?
Because it's been taken away from me. Give it back to me. Because this is what I teach is a very, very primal feminine movement. Our bodies know how to do this, and still they're scared not to do this, mm-hmm. or they're told not to do this. But when I, give it to them, it's like a sponge just sopping up this movement that they love, and it feels sensual and good. It feels delicious. You leave class with like a tripled endorphin high. You get a sexy high. You get a sensual high. You get a physical high. And you just float through the rest of your week because you're turning yourself on so highly.
And it's a great workout, so what a great way to work out and burn calories. You know what I'm saying? It's fitness.
You have to convince me, girl.
I saw you the other day, a couple weeks ago. Yes. I know
fun.
We have callers on the line. I still want to get to that fifth level, but I know we have callers on the line, and our very first caller... is she there? Do we still have her?
It's Taisha from New Jersey.
Hi, Taisha.
Hi. Can you hear me?
Huh? Yes, we can. Well, welcome to the Mary Lou Show. Do you have a question for Sheila Kelley?
Oh, my God. I just want to say that... Hi, Sheila.
Hi.
I love your work. It's so profound. It's moved me so deeply.
Oh.
And I've only taken an intro class. It's just from hearing you speak about this erotic creature and the power of the divine feminine in life to change everything. And I wanted to know more. My question is about how it affected your relationship with your husband. I know you were already...
I'm so sorry. Can you guys hang on 1 second? This show is moving so fast. We just got the cue. We have to take another break. Can you hang in there? Because this is great stuff, and I definitely
I'm going to answer that question to you. So
want to hear all about your experience.
Okay. If we could talk during commercial, that'd be
okay,
fun.
Okay, great. You got it.
Okay, thanks.
All right, thanks. We'll be back after these messages. Guest, maybe our hottest guest of all time. Sheila Kelley is here, who's an actress, author, speaker. She has the S Factor exercise DVDs and the S Factor fitness studio, 7 of them across the United States. She's having a live event that I'm very excited about. It's September 7th and 8th in Palm Desert, California. And we're talking to our first caller, Taisha, who just asked Sheila a question, and Taisha will be the lucky winner of the event. But could you come to the event in Palm Desert, Taisha?
Oh, I'm still there.
Oh, you are? Oh, great.
Yay.
Because it's not airfare, but you'll be able to go to the event.
Yes, that's not a problem.
Yay. I'm
so
excited.
Awesome. That's great.
Taisha, I want to answer your question because it's a very powerful question. What happened with me and my husband is when any one of two people, what I call awakens to the truth or awakens to their erotic creature, awakens into their true blossom of what they're meant to be here, which is a radiant, powerful, feminine being, if he doesn't awaken as well, he will be threatened. And I categorize men in 4 different categories. I call them A-men, B-men, D-men, or C-men. A, B, C, D, and I. If I tell you what they are, you'll probably go, okay, there's where mine lives right now, and this is why he's threatened. But the A man is what I call an altar man or an awakened man. He's the man at whose altar I worship because he worships at the altar of the feminine, and he loves the feminine. He wants her to radiate, and he feels confident that she will radiate all her energy toward him. The B man is what I call a boy man, which he doesn't quite know what to do with his masculinity yet. He hasn't quite settled, and so he's kind of erratic, doesn't know how to worship the feminine, tries to worship her, but doesn't really know it yet. He's learning. The C man is what I call the castrated man, a man who has lost his sense of virility, has lost his sense of his masculine. He can't hold his male presence. For many, many different reasons, it's life, work, other people, women, men, that challenge his masculinity. And the D-man is what I call the dick man, who's the man who kind of the world revolves around him and his penis. And that, of those men, who would you say your man is?
He's a B-man.
The B-man, yeah. So the good news is that the B-man and the C-man, can they can all be taken to the place of the A of an altar man. But they have to
go long for.
What, Sadie?
Which I so long for.
Aww.
Well, he has to desire to want to change. He has to desire to want to awaken. But I'll tell you how you're going to do it. You're going to call him into his best masculine self by becoming and stepping into your best feminine self. Because when you rise, he has to rise, or you won't be together.
And it'll be too much for both of you. I mean, it won't
That's
be the wrong
exactly
match
right.
for either of you.
You're absolutely
And you'll both
right.
know it. You know?
Exactly, Marilu. Exactly. So, my best to you, and I will see you in Palm Desert, young lady.
Thank you.
So, we'll have to get your, we'll get your information from you. And I know we have more guests. Thank you for calling in, Taisha.
So much.
We have another caller on the line.
We have Sarah from Minnesota.
Hey, Sarah. Thanks for hanging in there.
Good morning.
Good morning. Do you have a question for Sheila?
Yes, I do. First of all, I'd like the world to know that this is the most amazing woman in the world that you have on your show today.
I'm so excited. Thank you.
And second of all, Sheila, I had a question, which is, why is there so much pornography in the world today, and why are people so drawn to it?
I think that there's so much pornography in the world today because we live in a culture, a global culture, that has a very, very complex and dysfunctional relationship to sexuality. So we squelch sexuality in the male and the female, and what happens when you squelch something so natural and so beautiful is you stop it from coming out into the world, but it continues to grow, but it perverts. It becomes perverted inside. So you look for outlets for that sexuality that is still growing inside you, but growing all twisted and gnarled, as opposed mm-hmm. to opening up sexuality, making sexuality something that we celebrate, something that's wholesome, something that's beautiful and energetic.
And there's so much shame and hiding.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
there's like, and,
yeah.
and so that becomes the appeal. That the shame and hiding
exactly.
becomes like the stuff that you end up getting off on because you,
exactly.
you feel threatened by the real thing. So you there's like a shame and hiding, you know, involvement.
Exactly. Yeah. I hope that answered your question, young lady.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you for calling in. Okay, Jess, who else is on the line?
We have Maria from Los Angeles.
Hi, Maria. Yes. Welcome to the Mary Lou Show.
Good morning.
Hi.
Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. Good morning.
Hi.
So good. I'm glad you're calling.
Yeah, I was calling because earlier you were speaking of being in the feminine and getting out of the masculine, and I find it a challenge to be in my feminine without threatening the male and without the other women in the world who aren't there yet being upset with me. And so I guess I'm having a problem wondering what you do to stay there in the middle.
Well, you're talking about what you're talking about is modulating the voice of the body. Modulating your sexuality, modulating your erotic creature. And when you're, I don't know if you're an S Factor student, but come on by the studio, but when you learn how to flex the muscles of your feminine body through S Factor movement and through the pole and through the play, all of that energy is running through your body. So when you're in the studios, it can be very overt, very loud, big hip circles, lots of great big movements, 6-inch heels, I'm really hot. Erotic creature, but when you come out of the studio, I'm going to leave my 6-inch heels in the studio. That's something for my private enjoyment. But I modulate my sexuality. I don't shut it down immediately when I walk out. I allow that energy to course through my veins and through my curves. I lift my chest when I walk. I let my ass reach backwards. I call it stardust and sparkle. I sparkle forward and stardust behind. So that I'm radiating energy constantly. I allow all of that sexuality to flow out of me into the world. And, you know, I gaze at women in the eyes and smile. I get them to smile back at me. Instead of threatening women, I want women to feel connected to
me. Awakened. Yeah.
Awakened by me, turned on by me, not sexually, but excited, like turned on, like excitement, like, oh wow, I want to get that kind of energy too.
Right.
So
let me ask you something. What is the significance? What is the significance of the pole? And is it definitely part of every workout? Is the pole like
It is not a part of every workout. It's part of this. There's several things we offer. We offer this thing called the Journey Class. The Journey Class is the core of S Factor. It takes you through level one through level the practice, which is level six, level seven. And it is an awakening of the erotic creature in your body. It's an awakening of your body, and the pole is an element of it. For me, the pole is extremely provocative, and it's extremely fun. And,
yeah.
it's probably grounding.
It's probably grounding for people because there's something to hang on to, right?
Exactly right. It's very grounding, and it's also taking back control. It's taking back power. It's saying, you know, the masculine eye is no longer allowed to be the sole identifier. You're not allowed to just own everything. So if you want to own the pole in the strip club, it's all sexual. No, sometimes the pole is just fun. Sometimes the pole is just a vertical ballet bar. And so that's part of the fun of it. But it's also, I like being a bit of a troublemaker, so I like that it's naughty. And I love that. But in the studios, we teach a class called FFM, Fluid Feminine Movement.
Right.
And that has no pole whatsoever. That's just the luscious, round, curvy, what I call the rich, dark chocolate of the movement. And so we have all kinds of triptease class, we have pole class, we have FFM, we have different levels of pole classes, and we have the journey classes.
What do you say to the people who might be saying, well, you know, why are you using symbols that are so, you know, connected to a certain pornography or pornographic images or stuff like that? What do you say to, because I totally get what you're doing, believe me. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I played a stripper in a movie, so I did all my, and I totally get what you're talking about. And I know, you know, my husband and I and stuff and our relationship and what goes on in our bedroom. But what do you say to the detractors? he's definitely an A-man. No question about
it. Good. Yay.
You know, what do you say to your detractors?
Here's what I say. I say, and can I say this on your radio show?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe I'm only 2 months old, so I don't know what we can say
so
yet.
Okay, what I say to them is what came first, the erection or the hip circle?
Oh, right.
Because this idea of symbol to me is rolling over to the patriarch. It's rolling over to the masculine eye and saying, okay, the feminine eye doesn't matter. The feminine eye, but what we see, how we experience the world, doesn't matter. A pole is not a big erect penis to me. A pole is literally a ballet bar. It's something I can spin on, whirl on, I can dance with it. It is the best dance partner I've ever had. Richard, forgive me, I love you to pieces, but that's my husband. But it spins me, it swirls me, it holds me, I never fall down, it doesn't step on my feet. Greatest dance partner on the planet. So I'm going to take that out of the club and say, you know what? You know what, America? You may no longer own the pole as being something seedy. It's actually something really, really fun and wholesome. And by the way, if you've seen some of that really high-end pole work that's being done on YouTube and around the world, it is. It should be an Olympic event. It is.
Oh, absolutely.
Extraordinary athletic endeavor. But why should we?
Totally.
Why should we roll over and say, oh, well, when a man sees a pole, he sees a pole. We're okay. We live in
I love the vertical ballet bar. That's great.
Yeah, women have to step up, and they have to take their place, and they have to insinuate our point of view into the world, or we will forever be second-class citizens. We will
forever be
peripheral.
And I think that men, because they are so connected to their moms, they understand the miracle of birth because, you know, not that they'd want to do it and God forbid they should get their periods every month. But I think that men, you know, recognize the connection with their mothers and the miracle of just being able to create a body. I mean, talk about the ultimate multitasking, create a human being inside of you when you are, you know, doing everything. And I think that there's this reverse of power as a result because they know how powerful we are, and that's why it's time for us to take it back. We're going to be up after these messages. I know we have a caller, and I still want to hear about that fifth thing. So don't forget, we need that when we get back. And Sheila, you have to come back. More with Sheila Kelley after these messages.
Yeah.
Hey, we are talking to Sheila Kelley. I am so excited. She's my new best friend.
Hi.
We're already making plans for my class when I get back to Los Angeles.
Yay.
We are talking about, yes, the S Factor Fitness. She's incredible. I mean, it's crazy. She wrote a book called The S Factor Strip Workouts for Every Woman. She talks about, you know, just unleashing the female energy, the female power. And we have callers on the line, and we only have 5 more minutes to the show. I wish we had done the whole show on this, but we didn't. So now we can have her come back, and we can take our next caller, who is Pam. So, Pam, are you there?
I am here.
Hi, good morning.
Hi.
Hi.
Good morning. I apologize. I'm on the train on my way into L.A., but I just wanted to take the opportunity to say thank you for what you do, because I know for me personally, you've altered the path of my life, and as Dr. came to me at a time where I've just been fired, and I'm going through a divorce, and
wow.
What it offered me was the opportunity to really find like confidence and peace and sanctuary in myself. And it's just been remarkable, and it's something I try to tell everyone that that I know, and it is just such
it's life changing, isn't it?
It is. And like to go into a studio and to have the luxury of having, you know, a studio close that I can go to coffee at is my sanctuary. And I just wanted to thank you for allowing me that.
I hope you come to Palm Desert. I would love to meet you in person. But try and come to the event, will you?
I am going to try, yes. I am
good.
Going to
I would
try.
Love to meet you. And if you come, please come up to me and say, hi, I talked to her. Yay! Well, thank you.
That's
so
great.
Yes,
oh, thank you so much for calling, Pam. Thank
of
you.
Of course. Have a great day.
Thanks. Oh, doesn't that make you feel good?
It does. And it's really important, though, because most people go, oh, it's pole fitness. They don't understand what S Factor is. S Factor is really about feminine development. It's about developing yourself as a woman and a feminine creature. And when you walk into that studio, I've made it so that it's the safest, warmest, most nurturing place in the world. It feels like you're walking into a womb. There's no mirrors. There's no windows. It's quiet. It's dark. And the music's incredible. And you just start to really commune with who you are as a woman. And this love affair begins on the mat.
That's so great.
It gives you so much confidence and makes you feel so luscious and beautiful and radiant at every moment of your life. And that was very touching.
And this is for everyone. I mean, this is like all shapes,
every
sizes.
Woman.
Now, what about ages?
Because what I say is sexy has no expiration date.
Right. Of course. Period. Is there any youngest age? Do you have to be 18, 16?
You know, 18.
18.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Although I've tried to do, you know, teen classes where you, like, the sexuality is out of it. And it's literally just the feminine movement. And that's very, very, you know, the kids love it, but it's also a world that still has such a, like I said before, complex relationship with sexuality that they just don't know what to do.
Right. You'd have to have 4-hour classes to, like, deal with some of the things. We have one more caller on the line, and then we're going to have to say goodbye for the day. But, Keisha, you're on the line.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi, Keisha.
Hi, how are you?
I'm very well. How are you?
Good. I am with an A-man, and actually yesterday
he told me,
I wish you felt as sexy and sensual as I think you do. So, I never have, but obviously I'm either going to come to L.A. because I live in Riverside, or I'm coming to the clinic out in Palm Desert.
Oh, you know what? Come to the Palm Desert clinic, because you will be so blown away. Get online right now because it's selling really quickly, just so you know.
Okay.
Get online and go to the Palm Desert because I'll be there personally, and I will be working with people. I have 10 teachers. I'll have 20 poles. It's going to be like a rockin' party. And it's going to be just a great, great introduction to people who haven't done it yet. And here's the thing. I learned about the beauty of the feminine by sitting in strip clubs and watching the men watch the female body.
Right.
Men are, if we could only learn to see our bodies the way they do.
The way they do. That's a great point.
Yes.
Oh, Keisha, thank you so much for calling in. She's so great.
Okay. Say hi to me in Palm Desert, okay?
I will.
Yes. Keisha is a member of the MaryLou.com community, and she's amazing. Woo! And she's gone through this real health journey. She's lost weight, gotten over a lot. She talked about it on the show already about different, you know, issues and stuff. So she's incredible. She was, you know. But anyway, oh, Sheila, thank you so much for being with us. You must come back. I know. You must come back. You're coming back before it goes on the, you know, before your event.
Yes.
And
yes,
we'll talk more about it because there's so much to talk about. Thank you so much. And also thank you Ian Welch. We'll be up tomorrow live from New York City. You're listening to The Mary Lou Show. Thank you. It's Life Through the Prism of Health. See you tomorrow.